Greetings, fellow Oathlings. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall as a Mage. Now, we are in front of Castle Daggerfall right here, and I actually spotted another door over there that we could use, and this move right now to this tower right here, which is all amazing touches. I actually never really experienced Daggerfall this way when I was playing the DOS version, and look at that lightning, holy hell. Anyhow, so before I enter this place, I would actually like to talk about something that I may have not properly highlighted the importance of in the previous video. So in the previous video we learned that King Lysandus was killed in an ambush waylaid by orcs, essentially. Now, there's like a huge significance to it, because even though they don't really explain the lore of what happened to King Lysandus in-game, if you read the manual that the game came with, it's actually available on UESP, you'll learn that King Lysandus was known to have died in the Battle of Kringane Field. It's on this here, the isle. It's on this isle right here called the Isle of Betony. So essentially, this area was contested. This island was contested. It was initially like its own it had its own, you know, sovereignty. But then Daggerfall insisted that it fall under them, and one of the southern kingdoms, I think it was Sentinel, insisted that it should fall under them instead. And therein, they started fighting over it. Both the kings, King Cameron and King Lysandus, tried to have a peace talk over the fate of this island, and the peace talks also failed. So, as the story goes, as the official story goes, they fought a battle here on, I believe it is called the Kringane Field, if that's how you pronounce it. But yeah, there's some fields in this area where they fought that battle, and that is exactly where King Lysandus succumbed to his wounds, as the story goes. However, the issue with that narrative is that what we have just learned goes completely against that. According to the narrative that we now know, King Lysandus was actually slain. We don't know where he was slain, but he was slain in an orc raid, meaning that the shrine that has been erected for King Lysandus in the Isle of Betony is not his shrine, and that his body is actually not inside the shrine. So it's like a major lead for us, something that I unintentionally downplayed in the last video, so I thought I might as well go ahead and clear it out in the, you know, clear the air in this video that I'm recording right now. So that having been cleared, let us go ahead and enter Castle Daggerfall then. We are looking for a maid. So the reason that we're looking for a maid is simply because, you can hear monsters already. Yeah, it's simply because, what's her name? Morgia of Vedas told us to ask around at Castle Daggerfall, especially of someone at a lower station. And that someone at a lower station would be in the kitchen working right now. And they will give us more context about what happened to the Emperor's letter. So let us go and talk to him then. That monstrous sound every time you touch him. Yeah, the original game had like a lot of pointer errors, and this is one of them. All are free to petition His Highness at this time. Do not stray from the audience chamber, lest he have royal blessing to do so. Always speak politely to the king and queen, and above all, cast no spells while doing these walls to agree to these terms. Yes, but I am going to do both. Stray from the hall and cast a spell within these walls. What's interesting to me is that there's like this little inscription right here. Looks like a penis. With its ejaculate coming out from on top. Excuse me. Yeah, we're not here to talk to any of these guys. We are here to go downstairs and talk to Sisanda. Alright, so with that having been done, let me go ahead and save you. Yeah, right here. Because I don't know whether these guys are going to get aggravated when I open this door, or when if or when I, you know, cast a spell. So, here we go. The clatter of pots and pans and the smell of fresh baked bread waft through the door. Looks like none of these guys have been activated. Had to open it twice. Well, I've come in here and nobody cares, so here we are. Sindasa, right. So let us go and talk to her then. If I told you I could give you a bit of information, let's say about that letter of milady, would you be interested in it, strange blood? I thought so. Now mind you, I ain't giving it away. Before I scratch your back, you gotta scratch mine. Deal. My name's Sindasa. Daggerfall. Sindasa Daggerfall, that's your name. I suppose. I'll tell you everything I know, but I don't need to remind you that there ain't no such thing as free info to a strange blood. I'm just a maid to her highness. Nothing but a fleck to the world, and my needs ain't big. I need this werewolf done, and I know just where it is. Some kindred forsook hole called Tristore Laboratory, off the coast over Betony Way. I can't tell you why, but it's important to me that that werewolf gets put out of its misery. I'll wait here for 157 days for you. That ought to be plenty of time. Actually, quite a lot of time. Now, here's the thing about this quest. This is a fan patch called DaveQ Fix, which essentially fixes this quest. This quest initially was always supposed to send you to, well, Tristore Laboratory. And you've actually got two choices here. In the original DOS version of the game without DaveQ Fix, you would actually only get the version of the quest that was packaged with the game, because the devs more or less, since it was a rush game actually, even back when it came out, back in 1996, production issues. Anyway, they never changed, do they? So back when the game came out, it was rushed and the developers sort of forgot to patch in the alternate path. So with DFQ Fix, which comes pre-installed with the package, Daggerfall package from UESP, you actually always go to Tristore Laboratory, where you can find both the werewolf and a means to cure it. So here's the thing, we're actually not going to kill the werewolf here. We are actually going to collect some notes which would reveal the truth about this werewolf, and I'm not going to spoil it for the people who have not played this game before, but there's like a reason that she wants this specific werewolf dead, and it's actually a pretty sad reason. So playing as a character that would like to do some good in the world for a change, set things right, so to speak, I would actually like to save this werewolf, and you guys will find out what it is soon enough. Now then, now that that is done, I am going to cast a spell here, which is going to be a teleport spell. I'm going to set an anchor right here, and let's hope none of these guys... Perhaps it's time to learn, reflect on what you've learned about mysticism. Okay, none of these guys are activated yet. Or from the looks of it, they aren't attacking me, so I guess I'll just leave quietly while I still can. Right then. So, the werebeast. Tristore Laboratory in Betony. And yeah, we're going to the Isle of Betony then. It's strange that how there's literally no sun in the sky because of how heavy the clouds are. Ah, there's the sun. But I still can't cast any magic. Anyhow, we are headed to the Tristore Laboratory. Excuse me, thank you. And that is a part of the main quest, by the way. And we will travel there. I hope I have the money to travel there, actually. Wait, I think it might just be here. Tristore. Ripmore. Not exactly what I'm looking for, to be honest. Yeah, I don't think it's here. Betony? Ah, there it is. Tristore Laboratory. Bright orange. Trip cost 55 gold and 3 days of travel. Not an awful long travel time here. So our mysticism skill has improved, and the entrance to the dungeon should be right here. And our frames have returned in a splendid fashion. I love it. I wish like it would be the same thing in the cities, but I'm guessing there's some or the other odd issue that causes it to not be that way. I love the sceneries in Daggerfall. And one day I wish to actually travel the world without fast travel. But let's see, it can be pretty hectic. Now to find the... there we go. There it is. The entrance into the Tristore Laboratory. It's a damn hole in the ground. Alright, pre-dungeon save here. Alright, let's head inside then. Grab mode and equipped. Okay, nobody's here. That's good. Yeah, I just quickly want to keep this in my inventory. I already do have like a nice storm spell, but since this gives me a free spell anyway, let's go ahead and keep it. I'm gonna go ahead and equip that. And with that, I'm good done. Alright, I'm gonna make my... Holy shit! Talk about... Hey! Input lag! That is a goddamn battle mage. I didn't even hear it. Elven Daikatana. Alright. I'm quickly gonna cast invisibility before some more of these idiots show up. And let me just keep some of the stuff that I just got off of into the wagon. For example, the scorpion stingers and everything. Ah yes, let's put that into the wagon as well. Potion recipe definitely going into the wagon. Okay, what I want to do now is I just want to rest here. There are enemies nearby, of course there are. Why wouldn't there be enemies nearby? Okay, so I'm just gonna save here first of all. Alright, so which way are we headed then? Yeah, let's drop a bead on the other side. Let's head the other way. Any hidden doors here? None that I can see, actually. Not from the looks of it. Let us maybe take a left first. Who knows? So here's the thing, we can actually encounter the werewolf that we are sent here to kill right off the bat, and that is one of the main reasons that I've got invisibility equipped right now, because I did not want to accidentally encounter that werewolf. And yeah, hurt it. What the fuck do you think you're doing? Save versus spell mate. This one is swinging for the fences. Bad mage died. Cool. So this actually works. It just doesn't tell you when it works or not. Alright. Nothing else in here. So where are we headed now? It's gonna be a long dungeon crawl because there are like multiple... Let's check out the chamber first. There are like multiple... pages of a memoir of sorts for us to collect. That's that over there. There's nothing else really in there. We have checked it, right? Yeah. There's literally nothing else out there. So let me just go ahead and remove this bead from here. Yeah, thank you. And we'll proceed ahead. Or should we just... Yeah. I love this spell. Dwarven longsword. Amazing. I'm getting so much stuff right now. Should I... Let's just go ahead and rest. Why not? I don't hear any enemies. Alright, and we're gonna save in this slot here. Game has been saved, frames have been crushed to the earth. That classic sound of doors opening. makes you anxious, like really anxious early on in the game, doesn't it? Or should we just... Yeah, it's fun to do it this way. A song of ice and fire. That's what I call it. A palm, elven warhammer. Why am I getting so much good loot? Makes me feel that there's something off about it all. Okay, so I'm gonna head left first. We're probably gonna have to explore this area a lot before we finally get to the point where we wanted to get to. I hear something there. Something that I've heard before. Yeah, I hope there's not a lich in this place. That would suck. Okay. I was about to say time for the classics, but... Holy Tome. Actually, we can actually let go of the holy... Guttural sounds of the big children, what? We can, like I was saying, we can actually let go of the holy tome because it doesn't really do much for us. This module actually seems quite familiar. But I have no idea whether there will be anything upstairs. So I'm just gonna place a bead there. And if I'm not mistaken, there's gonna be like an entire cavern section up ahead. Yeah, right. Should I cast haste? Let's cast haste. I love full tooltips because it lets me know which of these damn skulls are interactable and which are not. But before I head there, I just quickly want to check out this section behind the window. Nothing here, as expected. That's typically the case, but sometimes there can be things beyond this wall, you know? Okay. Yeah. So you might need to run through it, crouch and jump, which is like a lot, asking a lot of you, but yeah, that's how it goes. Let me save here once again. So what's strange is the fact that you still need to... I should meditate on what I've learned about jumping. Shock, maybe? Hi. Holy hell, you've a weak. Or am I just that strong? Elven Tanto? These are all gonna sell for a lot. The air suddenly turns cold. I hear something there. I don't know what it is, but I hear something there. Okay, this was a dead end, thankfully. And from the looks of it, that's just a trap bit. Could have like visit rend or something along those lines. Should we try going up the stairs first then? Coil jump. Up the stairs or the other side then? I like how they also decided to include a sound of coins falling for the more greedy kind of adventurer. Good thing is I've got true invisibility, which means you're durable. I hear a pig, which is most likely a werebore. That sounds like a werebore, to be honest. Fairy dragon scales. Steel flail. Let us go ahead and update the save slot. So I sort of did realize that I don't use my dagger nearly enough for haste to be of any consequence, but still, it does something for me, so might as well keep it. And that looks like a zombie. Ah, that's what I could hear all this time. Interesting. Yay, bunny hop! Alright, there are two parts here. Which one should we take? We have not been here before. Let's explore the right. I have no idea where it might lead. Oh, hi. Hi there. Fuck you. Fairy dragon scales. Giant's blood, dwarven flail. Definitely elven greaves. I can carry those, but I can't sell those, so yeah. I'll just leave them be there. Yeah, let's eliminate that. Why are my spells fading away so quickly all of a sudden? I really thought I'd designed them to last longer, but apparently not. They just keep fading out, fizzling out pretty quickly now that I think about it. Okay, there's this. Alohomora, let's try it. Why not? Alohomora. Once more, because I seemingly have like a huge spell pool right here. Or not. Looks like they're bashing this door down the old fashioned way. I still like to cast Alohomora because, regardless of whether or not I manage to open the damn doors. Oh, come on, open up. Thank you. And of course there's nothing here, why would there be? Except for what seems like an elevator, to be honest. Do you take me down? Are you a shaft? You certainly seem like a shaft. Interesting. What's strange about this game is how the enemies cannot tell. Ah, we've come like full circle here. Interesting. Okay, so this area has been explored. So I guess we head back downstairs then. And clear out the rest of the areas that we have left untouched. Question is, do we want to head back downstairs this way, or do we want to like somehow use another way to get there? I suppose the same way that we came makes sense. But first, let me deposit some stuff into the wagon to reduce the burdens on my character here, including the dwarven longsword. That looks amazing. I just wish my character could. I allowed my character to use a wide variety of these things. I don't, that's just like on me, but yeah. With that being said, let us go and save you. Alright. I hear a Vereboar. I don't know where it is, but I hear a Vereboar. And I guess I'm supposed to take a right here, yeah. We're headed back to the levels below or stuff. Casting invisibility again? I could have sworn my invisibility spell used to last much longer earlier. I don't know what's going on. So since we're going that way, I hear a zombie. So what we're looking for, holy hell. Hi. One of you died, but the other one is still alive. Hi. You took a lot of shots, didn't you? Seals off. Iron longsword, basilisk's eye, dragon scale, small scorpion stinger, steel mace, not really interested in that. Yeah, right, cool. And if these are interactable, nope. There are no hidden doors here, so I guess we head back outside then. I can hear another zombie somewhere. I'm guessing this is the path that we took to come here. Yes, it is. So I'll go ahead and wipe that off the map as well. Now, I'll go downstairs first. Let's check out whatever's downstairs before we head that way. And, yeah. Essentially that. Hi there. I'll turn you into cinders yet. You too. Well, that guy died pretty quickly. Daedra's Heart. Interesting, you had a Daedra's Heart. Potion resist poison, chain greaves, leather cuirass, alright. Gold pieces, mummy wrappings, nymph hair, silver longsword, that's gonna sell for a bit. Could give me some travel change, you know. Ah, I see what was making all that noise. Hi. Why don't you come back here? Thank you. Now I'm gonna pick either of you up. I was literally just spamming spells to upgrade my destruction, which is one of my primary stats. Speaking of, let's go ahead and just check out. Yeah, strength is boosted to 66. Not a huge boost, to be honest. I've got 7,000 gold, 8,000 almost. Yeah, primary destruction. About to upgrade to the next level, and restoration actually has upgraded to the next level. Minor jumping is ready to upgrade. Oh yeah, we got that message in the mysticism. It has upgraded, or maybe it is ready to upgrade now. I can't really figure it out. Right then. Oh yeah, I think that's like an enchanted set because of how a wrap. Okay, there's like some loot here. There's also a bomb there, which I don't know what it does. Like, why is there a random bomb in the middle of nowhere? But yeah. So I guess this is also dead end. This dungeon does not seem that large as of right now, but you know what? Yeah, let's just go ahead and loot this guy as well. Lich dust. Good thing I came down here. Really good thing I came down here. Now time to cast levitate. Float. How much does Lumos is 17? Where's the invisibility? Spectral change 39. Not bad, not bad. The only thing that I dislike about levitation is how slow it makes my character move. I hear another zombie somewhere, and it's most likely. No, it's actually. The sound is coming from down there. I've heard that. Saving again, because I haven't saved in a while. Yeah, so. I've heard that. Did I take it off? Yeah, I did. My spells were vanishing on me, all of a sudden. yeah. Alright. There's a door here. Some more loot. Leather cuirass. That's practically useless to me. I'm gonna use only leather cuirass in my playthrough as a rogue. I see a person there. So I'm just gonna drop like a beat there. Sorcerer just died. Okay. Hi. Didn't really help you all that much, did it? Perhaps it's time to reflect on what you've learned about destruction. There's like a second floor to it and a floor upstairs. Alright, we'll get to all of those slowly. For now, okay, it's that. Alright, I think I recognize this one. It's probably the one with the throne room. This module, I mean. Yep, I think it's the one with the throne room. Let's just put a beat down here. And we'll come back to it later. For now, I just want to head downstairs first. levitation makes you move really slow, and that's literally the only thing that I dislike about it. Everything else about it is quite nice, to be honest. Hi. How did you attack me before you swung your sword? Okay, biography of Berencia. Cool, I better collect all of them before I get the order to. That's extra points for restoration. Demolish all existing copies. And look at that! Flute has been active for a really long time. But the rest of these aren't. I wonder why. Alright, we move forward. I should probably rest sometime soon, but that's the thing about being a mage, especially with the regenerating magicka pool, that you do not really need to rest all that much. Let's just go ahead and use a little mortar. Why be a brute when we can put... We've got a perfectly working open spell. Okay, a round shield and 50 gold pieces, that's all there was. Alright. I hear something moving about there. This seems to be the throne room. Or not. Ah. There's a zombie there, of course there is. Because why wouldn't there be a zombie there? Nothing here. Just a poisonous mist spread all over the place. And we're now back down here. Should we? Yeah, let's go. This is probably gonna hurt a bit, but here we go. So these guys start aggroing as soon as they start getting damaged, and then they just go bonkers. But let us hit it with all the variety that we had. All the variety of spells, I mean. I don't know if it hit him or not, but it did something. Steel Veil, Tar Shield, Steel Claymore. Yeah, right. Not really interested in any of those things. Looks like we're gonna have to bash this door down as well. Anything here? Gold pieces and a clover. So, dungeon crawling is rewarding in the sense that it gives you lots of things from enemies. Far more so than actually... I mean, the loot that you get is much better than all the... Excuse me. Yeah. Than all the... than any reward out there. I sort of want to change over to the ebony staff, almost new, right. Let's go nick with that. So the longsword, don't really want to use it. So, as far as I recall, I didn't see any other doors to this little section here. So, we'll let this be. Alright, let's head back then. Since we have mostly cleared this section. We have, right? Yes, we have. There is nothing else here, just checking the walls for any hidden doors. None. There are no hidden doors. Alright then, so we come back here and that'll just make us drop down into that place that we came from. Yeah, nothing of value there. Just a dead guy. Now, here lies the question before us. Should we explore that side or that side? You know what, let's explore that side. Let's clear the path up top first. Where are we? Yeah, right there. I wish the zoom on the dungeon map could be fixed. This woman here detected me. But she can't see me because I'm invisible. Sorcerers are weak, unfortunately. Anything of value? Nothing. Saving again. Because why not? Because if and when the game crashes, it's gonna be mostly an annoyance to come back. Yeah, thought it might come out here. We're gonna place beads on both sides because for now we are mostly concerning ourselves with this door, even though it's most likely a dead end. Yep. With nothing but a sorcerer inside. Sorceress. Hi. Thank you. Nothing else. I just want to lunch money is all. So before we head down there, what I want to do is move that into place first. Look at the green mist surrounding the place. Yes, let's go ahead and explore this side because that'll essentially complete the loop. You might also come across some hidden tools in the process. Hi. How does it feel to get shocked? You know, holy hell, look at you. That was a triple attack. Griffin's feather. Interesting. Now, these will all be like really good once I start. I think there's a hidden door right there somewhere, like across the gap, I believe, if I'm not wrong. Like somewhere over here. Right next to one of these gaps is typically hidden door. Yeah, right here. See? It sometimes has a Gorgon snake. Oh, like the hair of a Gorgon. An enchanted common symbol. Interesting. I never thought that these things could be enchanted. I hear a werewolf. Or a werewolf. I am ready to advance further in illusion. So that's one of the sad parts about what are you? A werewolf hostel, right? I'll just let the wolfie be for now, because that might just be a target. I won't touch any of these guys here. Yeah, chain drive portal, scorpions. Stingers, scales, yeah, right. Okay, so that more or less brings us over to the other side now. There's also like a little lever up there, which I don't know how we're gonna get to it. Actually, come to think of it, I've actually never been there before. So why don't we go ahead and explore it now that we have the opportunity to do so. I'm curious to see what changes this will make. Oh yeah, I've actually been here before. That was my bad, I've been here before. This is like an alternate, there is a path through there which brings us all the way here. Yeah, it was sort of stupid of me to bring the lever here. But with that being said, we do not want to harm this werewolf, because that is most likely the quest objective here. Instead, what we want to do is head back and of course close the store. Find some pages is what we are trying to do here, essentially. I just want to close the loop and then we are free to explore the rest of this dungeon as we please. But yeah, kindly do let me know if and when I've closed the loop. Not yet from the looks of it. There are a few areas yet unexplored, like this area right there. And yeah. Nox. Sorry, Dumus. Hi there. That is a very powerful spell that I've made. What are the stats to it again? Joe Mama? Yeah, continuous damage health. 1 plus 12 per 3 levels. And okay, that's like just the duration. 15 to 20 per 3 levels. Holy hell, that is a very powerful spell indeed. It's like every 5 seconds it does like 20 points of damage to the target. That is something else altogether. Alright, so we have apparently been all the way up here. So the only thing that remains for us is to explore this side. So I guess we're gonna go ahead and do that then. Let us zoom in a little and yeah. Let us remove that from there and we are headed straight. Slowly floating through the void. That's what we're doing. I sort of want to revamp the Jumama spell and make it do more damage. I recast invisibility accidentally, did not mean to do that, but yeah, here we are. There's some volatile magicka in the area. Holy hell, how did you know it was there? I guess you didn't, you just randomly swung your sword and found my body. Okay, we're almost out of health here. But before I get to that guy, I just want to quickly check out the rotting corpse here. Hi. Hmm. It's like, these guys have like 40 health or something. Helm, potion of water walking, sure. And a red bulb, northern red bulb at that. Let me just go ahead and save you. New slot, of course. I probably used to save more when I was originally playing the game. I don't need to save as much now because as a mage, this game is sort of broken. This guy went ahead and decided to aggro somebody. I don't know who, but yeah. This guy decided to totally aggro somebody. Alohomora! Of course it failed. Again, let's try it again. Alohomora! It failed again. Let us watch the spectacle unfold before us then. And we'll fight the winner. A zombie and a battle mage. Well, that was a quick victory. Mostly meant to do that, but I guess it missed this guy. Hi. I heard a door opening and I do not like the way I heard it at all. I've got no idea what sounds I'm hearing over there, but I do not like them. And that being said, let us go ahead and update the save. I feel like I might need it. The save that I just made. The sounds in this game are far creepier than the actual enemies. That's just another zombie there, a rob zombie. And another one of these battle mages. Question is, where am I headed? Just another zombie, you two can fight it out. Where am I now? A totally unexplored area. Cool. So we're gonna just go and drop B there and there. And take the full stride. See wherever it leads us. Pass some broken pieces of stone. I'm guessing this is most likely under the V from the Is it? I hope it is not. It is. Oh no. I hate this section. Oh no, I really do hate this section. I'm mostly not bothering myself with these enemies here, if you can call them that. Did I make the mistake of saying that this dungeon is not expensive? I guess I did. Should not have made the mistake of saying that. So yeah, let's put a bead up there. I'll deal with it later. I'm not in the mood for it right now. Oh yeah, fine. Right, I was overcomplicating things. That's what it was. We came out on the other side. Mummy wrappings. And really nothing else of value here. There's typically supposed to be another door right here. Yeah, right here. Which leads us to an altogether different area of the map. Alright, I guess we'll go and explore that. Then we'll come back and explore the rest of it. But this looks like it leads back to the entrance here. So maybe... yeah, maybe let us go and explore that. If that is the case, then we'll figure things out for ourselves. I was expecting to have to spam it, but yeah, I didn't. It just... oh, there's a map. A freshly drawn map indicates the long-lost location of the Cabal of Gwynona, which you copy down. So, a Cabal is typically a... witch's haunt. Oh hey, I think I see a page there. And this must be a werebore. Yep. A healthy stout werebore. Letter of the Daggerfall Court. Now let us go ahead and boom this werewolf. Sorry, werebore. Let's see how long it takes to actually destroy itself. Sort of stuck here, to be honest. So every time that it gets damaged, the game automatically reveals its position to you. I'm just gonna quickly take out this thing right here. Let us go ahead and shock you then. Help you along your way. And this thing has no... nothing whatsoever. But with that having been done, let us go ahead and... read this letter that we got, the Daggerfall code. Use. You find a date diary fragment written in a scrawling hand. I cannot believe Sindasa acted so spitefully just because I broke up with a friend, Tristore Ashley. Well, I never much cared for visiting Burning Light of Kindred either, and though we parted amicably, but being to turn me into the shapeshifters, I just won't get it. Sindasa must be picking a bad face from those rotten nobles at the Daggerfall Court. I see. So, this creature apparently knew Sindasa. That's interesting, don't you think? For some reason, there's this little dot placed down there. Even though we have explored that section, so let us go and remove it. It turns out it's just a dead end, nothing else. Cool then. I guess that makes that section completely explored. We just need to explore the other side. Go over, deposit some things into the dungeon, explore this side. Hopefully it's a short exploration journey, because I feel like the majority of the dungeon is over on that side. So with that being said, yeah, let us go ahead and deposit some stuff into a wagon, and then we'll be back. Here we go. Alright, so what all can we get rid of? This wrap. Oh, it's a piece of clothing. I thought it was something else. The Daggerfall code? No, I do want to keep that. Common symbol? We do not know what it does. Neither do I want to know. For now, that's going into the dungeon, so is the only candle. Because we have no idea what it does. Chained Red Pauldron, why do we even have that? I'll drop it on the ground the first chance I get. Or maybe we'll sell it, who knows. It doesn't really matter at this point, does it? Since we do not exactly have a field alchemy kit yet, I'm just going to keep all that where it belongs. And let's rest. So since I've cleared this part of the dungeon, I doubt there would be any enemies here, but still. So I think if my memory serves me correct, there are supposed to be 3 or 5 odd pages for us to gather, to be honest. And let's go ahead and place a bead there. We'll search it on the way back. I'm not really in the mood for you right now. Did you just trigger me, little bitch? Why don't you take that? And that? I was about to spare you, but then you just had to swing at me, didn't you? That too with an elven longsword that looks like a hammer. I don't know how that works, don't ask me. Alright, here we are. I'm too far away, apparently. There's loot pile there, fairy dragon scales. Gold pieces. So one of the things that you do not want to do is throw area of effect spells at sorcerers. The ones wearing chainmail, like mine. Because what that does is it just recharges their spell slinging capabilities, and that's honestly the last thing that you want. That was a hefty bit of damage there, Nymphaeir. A lovely door. That was easy to open, and of course there's nothing inside, because why would there be? So what we're looking for right now is another one. Watching the moon rise over Castle Daggerfall. So the location of all these letters are fixed. I just don't know where to get them. Because it's literally the first time that I'm solving the quest this way. Okay, Carson Sentinel, not those. Yeah. You find a diary fragment written in a clear hand. I have no memory of coming to this place. If I've been kidnapped, for what? We have no money, and Sindas is barely tolerated by the nobles at boot. My last clear memory is of watching the moon rise over Castle Tagfall. So this person is very well connected to Sindas somehow. I don't know who he is, I'm just narrating it in a fashion that is suitable for you guys. Seemingly we've been here before. We have been here before, yes, we have. Ah, okay. Alright. I just took a right when I should have gone straight. So since there's not much there except for just some combat and I'm invisible, I'll just go ahead and fail. Why fight battles that are unnecessary, right? Right. Alright, so I'll mark that area as covered and there is seemingly something here. Ah. A damn sorcerer is what it is. Excuse me. Thank you. 12 arrows? Why did I pick that up? Potion of water walking, right. Let me just go ahead and drop some things from my inventory, such as these 12 arrows here. And what else was there? Yeah, that's it. So there's nothing else here, right? Right. So I went ahead and removed that, and I don't think I found any other letter fragments up there. So I guess what remains now is to head back downstairs. Essentially, go all the way here. Like, exit this place and head straight to that part. Because there are like lots of areas that we have left unexplored back there. None that I can see over there. Even though the map, despite Unity's advancements, are not that good. But yeah, we need to head back there and explore the rest of these places that we've neglected to explore. So with that being said, let's go back then. Time to run, because I hate wasting time. Okay, with that being done, though, let me just go and save you. We're back with the frame sound. Hoping they'll come back soon. Yeah, they're there. So that's a target favorite right there. The one that you do not want to kill. Because it is somehow connected to Sindas. Not only connected to Sindas, but also important. So that's one of the reasons why we do not want to kill that werewolf. Do you guys want spoilers about who the werewolf is? Well then wait around until we find the next letter. Probably somewhere up here. Yeah, I feel like shocking you. And bullying you at the same time. I'll wait for you to die on your own terms. Thank you. Giant's blood. Since you've died already, might as well go ahead and loot you. Nectar. Yeah, that's it. Nothing more. I wonder if the other guys. This, by the way, a secret door here, which is uber obvious in this version of the game. Wasn't as obvious in the DOS version though. Let me just go ahead and save though. Once more, just for the sake of it. Yeah, let's complete the save. It's strange, saving just makes the game brighter all of us. Holy hell, did you see that knockback? Bamboo, scarab, iron saber, helm, silver greaves. That's gonna sell. Not for a lot, probably like 200 gold coins or whatnot, but it'll give me some chump change, you know. So yeah, we have come full circle now. We still do need to figure out how to essentially what's behind door number one over there. Now, there is a way to find out. We can either go there or we can just walk down there. Either way, you get where you want to go. Because the path down here essentially connects to that door over there. Invariably. There's no way around it. The structure of the dungeon might be different inside, but the path does invariably connect to the store here. Hi there. Shocking, isn't it? Isn't it, bro? Hi. How does a face full of stars stop for you? How about getting hit over your head with one? You've got invisibility, but so do I. Actually, you don't have invisibility, you're a battle mage, you've only practiced destruction magic all your life. I would hate to get hit by one of your spells, but that does not mean that you are invulnerable to the rest of my spells. And that was a pretty short tour. Okay, not much there at all. I mean, nothing there whatsoever. So we're on the hunt for the third and final page there. Now, we're gonna find it somewhere over there. Question is, how are we gonna get there though? So we essentially need to take the door at the very end of that thing there. So let's just take a shortcut and levity to it then. Because why not? That's how the professionals do it, right? And we'll start off that side over there. Alright. Cost of these, thank you. I do not want to endanger the life of the werewolf, being the reason why I'm not even attempting to strike that guy, that sorcerer over there. Oh yeah, I closed that door myself, yeah, I remember now. Wait, that's the wrong way. We have to take this door here. I think werewolves know how to open doors, but I'm not certain. I'm pretty sure they do know how to open doors, just that I don't think they have the mental capacity remaining to do that. An evil laugh echoes past, really? Huh. Okay, so where are we headed next? Straight downstairs from the look of it. Or are we? Curious. Where did all the... Why does it feel like I've come to the wrong place here? Yeah, because all the marks over here, the marks that I'd left previously, they're all over here on this side. How the hell am I supposed to get there? Excuse me? So this will take me up there, and that will take me back there. Which... Where does it take me? Oh my god. Yeah, I feel like I've stepped through the wrong door here. So the reason I'm saving so often is so that when Unity crashes, like when DFU crashes, as it so often does when recompiling stuff, my progress remains saved. Okay, so... Alright. I did come the wrong way. So which way did I come from again? Oh man. Am I supposed to head that way? Or... what? Yeah, I'm supposed to head back. We've already covered this section. Completely. We have to actually head through the secret door. Not the secret door, but rather the door beside the lever on the other side. That was my bad mistake. This door? No, the other one. The one over there, that one. Here we go. Dead bodies everywhere. just what I'd like to see, even though it sounds very maniacal. I'm guessing I did actually cover all the way. Wait, so how am I supposed to get to that place where that I have not covered yet? Excuse me? Hmm. Oh, okay. I'm supposed to go in and take... That's totally on me. I totally got turned around in this dungeon. And then again, these dungeons are pretty labyrinthine. Turns out that was the right way. I said to take a left, it said. Foolish me. So, I'll take it out on you then. Since I made a mistake. Two bombs, a helm, and nothing else really. Alright then. I thought this was like an empty chamber, but apparently it was not. You too. Since, we got lost, we need to entertain our viewers. And we'll begin with you. Okay, so we'll go ahead and take left first, check out whatever there is on that side. I remember there being a battle mage there, that's for certain. Joe Mama. Let's see how long it takes to die. You don't know where you are, do you? Where I am, do you? You're just randomly swinging for the fences. At the same time, getting damaged. Since you damaged me, let me go ahead and return the favor there. Which I did. Time to level up my restoration a little. Okay, we have two choices here. Let us go ahead and head straight first. Actually, take a right first. We can head straight later. The float spell is finally giving out, which is good. Okay, although more do I dare. Actually, let me go and save it first, because I haven't saved in a while. I don't want the game to crash. Oh, right. Since the spell effect failed, and I would rather have a little bit of magicka available to me at the end of it all. Let us not. Waste our spell points on it. Excuse me. Can you, like, thank you? I see you there. And I raise you. Some fireballs all over you. Headshot. You're durable. Steel fail, hell. Okay, is there anything here? Or did I just somehow bypass the last page then? Like, was it somewhere right in front of me and I just totally missed it? I doubt that happened because I really think the chances of that happening are low, but never zero. If that indeed did happen, then we'll just have to explore the rest of this dungeon again, or I could just go ahead and tell it to quest marker and get it done with as well. Okay, so I essentially did not search the other side. Right. So I'll remove this bead first and we'll take a ride here. Actually, let's open this door and check it out. There's just a zombie there, and let us not disturb the dead. I'm gonna close this door. Although I think zombies know how to open doors, but still. You died. Haha, gotcha. Tomes of Arcane Knowledge. Now then, where are we headed next? Let's place a bead down there. And let's head down this route first. Seems like it might just be a chamber, a holding chamber of sorts. Or not. Or not. Oh yeah, it is. Just a sorceress there. A battle mage, nothing else. Either. Too bad you can't see or hear me, even though I've got this huge halo right about myself. But you do you. You do you. Since we have come all the way here. Okay, did this actually come out? Huh. Let's head downstairs first. I hear a zombie. I don't know whether that is a Rob zombie or not, but I hear a zombie. Aloe Mora, right here. I dislike how expensive the Aloe Mora spell is. I hear another zombie, which I do not really want much to do with. Good thing is that the enemies can't hear you when you're bashing down doors. Just a cheer there, probably for torturing somebody. There is a possibility of Wibble's blood. Right then. Nothing here. Let's head back out then. Oh, why are these guys just climbing all over the place, I wonder? Was there like a hidden door back there? Not from the looks of it, no. Alright, I guess we're headed the other way then. I hope to find the last page, really. Unless there are only two pages, who knows. Anyhow, I'm just gonna go ahead and save you. If we explore the entirety of the dungeon, this place looks like it might hold one of those pages. These guys move loud, don't they? Where did I come out here? No clue. It's like a totally new place that I just came out of. That place over there with the bead. Yeah, where is this bead located? From the looks of it, we have already explored that area. Why is there still a bead there? Maybe we discovered it by incident. I did not see any hidden doors there. Yeah, since this has been discovered by incident, I guess there's only one more place left in the dungeon for research, and that is pretty much the area that we are exploring currently. Okay, we're gonna explore that area later as well. Did I say that this dungeon is small? I did not actually mean that. With the power of hindsight, I mean. Did I just recently say that? I can't recall. Alright. Heading forward. I see a battle mage. Don't care about you. Okay. Where have we come out now? Oops. Yeah. Let's check out the right side. Hello, Amora. Let's fight next. Of course, the spell effect failed. I'm just looking for the last page at this point. I really don't care about. Oh, this room. This looks so much different in the Unity version. In the DOS version, it looks so charming, especially with the globe in the middle, but I guess there's no globe in the middle in this version. Let us go ahead and remove that bead from there. I see another sorcerer. Excuse me. Caustic liquid has scarred the floor. Caustic liquid, eh? I'm just gonna place a bead there and let us explore this, I suppose, since there's a door here. Is this the stairway downstairs, or was that someplace else? Since we are coming this way, let's go ahead and explore it, I guess. A sorceress. I've had my fill of fighting. Don't really want to fight as of right now. So I'm guessing we came out on the other side of the hall? Not really, no. I don't know where we came out, but... Oh. this piece has this thing as well? Oh, okay. This is an expansive place. This piece is huge. I feel like I'm deviating way off course right now. Because this is going to be like an entire cavern system which is as well. You know, before I go ahead and explore any of these areas, let me just go ahead and place beats down all over the place. And I really feel like I'm getting way too far ahead of myself here at this point. Okay, it's strange. We came from here, but we... I started exploring this side, but I don't recall ever coming here. Oh yeah, we decided to go upstairs first, I see, alright. Since we have explored that side, I guess it's time we go ahead and start exploring this side then. Yeah, we have explored this side. We did it unintentionally. We placed a beat down there, but we explored it nonetheless. I hear zombies. But all I'm really looking for is just a door. Oh, sorry, just a letter. That's all I want, literally. Nothing else. Nothing else but just a letter. And if I recall correctly, I might just be getting way off track here. But then again, I'm not certain. So yeah, if by the end we do not find the letters, we're gonna just use cheats because I'm a little too tired to be exploring this dungeon all over again. Alohomora, why not? I'm not gonna be able to open this door because it's too high a level for me, but I can always try. This will open up at the bottom in that place that we just saw. Yeah, let's go and save you. I don't recall if there were 5 or 3 pieces of the letter. This poor guy is stuck inside. Northern Twix. Why are you guys all aggro? Alright, so let us travel then upstairs into the entire cavern system. Why is this place so expansive? Typically these cavern systems are even more expansive. What am I getting myself into? Did I somehow miss the letter? I've got no idea. At this rate, I might as well just go ahead and let's place a beat down there. I hear a fair boar, but I'm not really interested in conflict right now. I'm just looking for the letter. I don't really want to waste any more time than is necessary. Why is there a random... Oh, wait a minute. This is like a door that has been opened. Of course. I passed it and now I am trapped. You know what? Let us go ahead and save the emergency slot right here. Should have probably saved before. Yeah. Here's what's going to happen. I'm just going to use these two save slots from here on out. 1 and 2. I'm not going to touch save 3. Oh. I see, you just need to step in front of it to get it to open. So I guess I was just overreacting a little. Alohomora? Well, it opened up pretty quickly nonetheless. Alohomora? Of course it failed. Why wouldn't it? I hear a weird boar of sorts in there. Ah, it's this module. I'm in Tristore Laboratory. Why do I hear that sound? That's not a good sound to hear. At all. Typically this is a house. This is typically supposed to be a house that has nothing of value. I've never actually seen this module connected to anything. And if this is the module that I think it is, there's a lot more to this dungeon. A lot more. It's like a mishmash of every single dungeon module I've ever seen. This is supposed to be locked. Like, fuck off. I was about to say this is supposed to be a room with no end to it. Instead, it turns out to be a room with an end to it. Now, here's the thing though. This seems to have brought me back to a place that I apparently have come near to exploring before. So let me go ahead and drop that. Remove that from there and drop that there. And let us continue exploring on this side. I've got no interest in any sorcerers whatsoever. I wonder why the door is open there. Have we come here before? No, we haven't. I'm just gonna go ahead and save here. Actually, we're more or less free to use save slot 3 as well. Who tried slinging a spell at whom? Is what I would like to know. Lomora. What's more? Ah, there was a battle mage in there. Probably fighting against a zombie of sorts. From the sounds of it. Yep. Probably because I opened the door is the reason why the battle mage died there. I love knowing the fact that I'm the harbinger of a lot of people's tombs. Now, one of the bad parts about not killing anybody is the fact that since we have covered all that, you need to carve out rest areas for yourself. Like this, very little remaining place for you to rest. Now, this place has a lever here, which I don't know what it does actually. I've tried pulling this lever multiple times, but let us pull it nonetheless. I think it just, no. That's this lever. Yeah, let us ride it all the way down. I think that lever does something, I'm not sure though. But yeah, I'm gonna check as many nooks and crannies of this place as I can. Probably should not have saved there. And we have checked that area, we have checked that route as well. Yeah, so what I meant to say was I probably should not have paused the game here, because if this is anything like the original Daggerfall, no, it isn't. Because in the original Daggerfall, if you pause to open the map or whatever else it is while you're on an elevator, you're gonna fall hard. Yeah. So this area is supposed to have like a bunch of flywheels. Yep, there's like an entire area down there. This area typically has like a bunch of flywheels, which two flywheels there, and apparently a woman guarding it. Yeah, this is usually the dungeon entrance in these cases, to dungeons that have this as a beginning module. This is supposed to be like an entirely different module of its own. No. So there's something up there, which we can more than definitely check out. I like how... Oh, okay. I guess one of these five wheels actually opens that gate over there. Difficult to tell which one it is though. And I am getting tired, so I guess I'll just dispose of the people up there and rest. Yep, that's the one that opens this gate right here. Here we go, floating through the void. And more enemies than I recall here. That flywheel probably addresses that gate over there. Good to see that I did not bother that guy. There's typically like another lever here as well, but I don't see it in this case. Alright, nothing here. I'm not going to touch that flywheel because all it's going to do is lock the space. Oh, the lever is placed right here in this case. So what this lever does is, I'll show you guys. By the way, this will cast low fall on you. never use it. Slowfall sucks unless you have no choice whatsoever. Do not use it. So, you see this wall right here? It's gonna pull this wall down and bring this wall up, which is going to give you access to some loot back there. You know what? Let's just check it out nonetheless, since we are doing all of this. Yeah. Yeah, you see? That wall gets transported over to the other side. There's typically some kind of monster down there, some kind of monstrosity, and some loot, and that's literally all there is to this lever right here. But down there is also where you might find some quest objectives. But I don't think we did have to come all the way in here just to get those quest objectives. So in that regard, I feel like maybe we have perhaps traveled a little too far in the process of searching for whatever it is that we're looking for. Right, so we'll start off with this door. Did not expect anything to be here, even though what we're looking for can very well be there. And there's going to be another elevator right here that we can take to get upstairs. I do hear like a zombie moaning loudly right into my ear, but given the fact that there are no hidden doors there, I'm willing to wager that this zombie, yeah, doesn't know much. Like, the zombie isn't here, essentially. So I've heard that Daggerfall has dungeons lined with inaccessible rooms. And that's probably what we're hearing back there. All this effort just waiting for the elevator to come down. Why are you so slow? Why are you so slow? I would like it if you were a little faster. Now then, to the other side. That's curious. I've never seen these before. Okay, pre-interact. Typically here, there's a gate. Okay, that takes it back upstairs. Gotcha. And what does this do? Does it pull up the wall here? Maybe? No? What did that do then? Curious. Maybe it opens the gate. I guess we won't know until much later. Anyway, back down you come. Maybe it calls. Yeah, it calls this elevator up. Never mind. Those are just switches for these two elevators. Typically those switches are right here, but in this instance I have to go all the way there and come all the way here. But typically these switches are placed right here, right next to each other, but for whatever reason right now they're all the way here. And with that, let us go ahead and rest here in front of the fire. And yeah, let's update the save. Let us go ahead and cover the rest of the areas that we have not covered yet. And once we have done that, we'll just go ahead and tell it to quest mark or something. Food. There's this guy right here. Now, where are we headed is the question. We have checked out all of those spaces. There's nothing there whatsoever. No letters of any sort. And so I'm mostly just interested in the areas that we have left untouched thus far, that we have not explored yet. That's all I really want. Just the areas that we have not explored. I do recall seeing like a bead somewhere over yonder, maybe? Or perhaps somewhere over here. But no, we have actually explored the entirety of the map. I guess I must have missed the damn letter somewhere then. Well, let me just go ahead and quickly read through the walkthrough. Let me use the console command now, because I'm not exactly eager to do it all the way here. Like, do it all the way again. All the way over again. Tell it to queue marker, right. This keeps teleporting us right back here. Actually, tell it to queue item, I think. It's depreciated. Deprecated. I think. Yeah, nah. Wait, let me just go ahead and first of all, let me just look up the. Yeah, since we're here. Let me just go and save. It is quite possible that I completely missed one of the pages in one of my searches. Because I feel like I've explored all of these areas. Whoa, I thought I saw a bee. No, I did not. No, we have explored the dungeon in its entirety, I feel like. So yeah, this is the point where we use tell to quest marker, but since I don't know what it is, the command that gives me all the quest items in my into my inventory, I'm just gonna go ahead and pause right here. Okay, my apologies, Sat. I was a dumbass and didn't realize that there are actually, in fact, only two diary entries. No, not three. But I would apologize, but remember the fact that we're in the same boat and you guys are stuck with me, so yeah, I'm not gonna apologize. Fuck you all. So yeah. Now that we're out of here, yeah, we did save recently. The clue essentially, oh yeah, right. Why did I pick this helmet again? It's just +3 to armor. At any rate. Anything else I want to put into the wagon, perhaps? Prayer beads, icon, tombs of arcane knowledge. We could definitely read those, but we don't really want to as of yet. Yeah, so the clue as to where to head next is literally in this. Cristolda Ashley. Gallowick. Cristolda Ashley in Gallowick. That's where we need to head. And that's why there's like such a huge time limit to this quest. Alright, let's head to Gallowick, which I hope is somewhere here. Or is it in Daggerfall, I wonder? Most likely, yes. I still dislike how this. Holy shit, we've got 5,000 gold pieces. Right then. I really should have taken this vest off, but oh well. Yeah, we are looking for Cristolda Ashley. Hello there, good sir. Good day to you, strange but polite. Can you tell me Cristolda Ashley? I don't know nothing. Alright. Be that way then. There's a residence. I did not want to enter there. Okay, why do you look like that? Could have asked him as well, but alright. Yeah. Hello, my friend. Normal. Greetings to you. Do you know where Cristolda Ashley is? I don't particularly care to be your lackey, strange, but run along now. Okay, that was a change in. A drastic change in. attitude there. Could you perhaps help me? It's really easy. You want to go southeast of where we're standing. So that's that away. This perhaps wouldn't be the place, would it? Well, Gallowick is a pretty small place. And let's hope to find some kind of person here who might give us directions. She's either in a tavern or in a house. So we just need to figure out which one it is. It must get really uncomfortable walking around in chainmail all day long. Let me just go and identify this and then talk to the woman back there. Hello there, Eliza Buckencroft. Can you tell me more about Crystal Astley? Good day to you, strange, but you guys are polite, aren't you? Why on Tamriel would I want you to know? Good question, I guess. Yes, Crystal Astley. There's no reason to talk down to me like that. I can't help you anyway. Well, I did not talk down to you, kind sir. Yes, you do. Halt! What you're going to want to do is go very nearby. Here, I'll show you the nave and fairy on your map. Wait, I think it was mentioned on the letter? I think? Shapeshifters. Galovic. Nave and fairy, nope. Okay, where's the nave and fairy? All the way across the other side of the map. Then again, I guess it is southeast. My guess was at least correct that we had to head southeast. I'm assuming... Nope, that's a rat in the stack. So where's the... Yeah, right here, I suppose. The nave and the fairy. Where's the sign? Where's the sign? Right there. So the door should be right there. Some of these doors are in the corner. Oh, it's already nighttime? No, it isn't. Crystalda Astley, good to see you. Yeah, let's talk to you. Why, strange bird, you found part of my old brother's diary. I'd recognize that handwriting anywhere, or rather, writing anywhere. Sindasa, that the filthy little whore had him infected by two different loops. Really? Hearing such is beyond our means today. The Beldama hopes through study to find one. She can reverse the process for several weeks, but no longer. Until now, we've seen no case survive the initial infection any longer than that. If you can return with him to me, I have some information that may be of some use to you. Take the special item. It will tame the beast within him. On second thought, strange bird, why don't I just drag along? I'll hold the icon, as it can be a bit tricky to use. Cool. My reputation with her is high enough to where she's actually escorting me. Amazing. So with that being said, let us go ahead and save the game here once again in case it crashes. Right then. We are headed back to Tristore Laboratory. I keep forgetting to take the vest of the Orc Lord off, but it's alright. I have enabled magic repair for this playthrough, since I find the inability to repair magical items a little tedious. So, and given the persistent dungeons board, we won't really have any other enemies to really, you know, worry about either. Crystalda Astley begins whispering. Okay, strange, but here's what we'll do. We'll split up and make our way to Tristore Laboratory. Then while you distract him, I'll cast a spell to tame the beast within him. So the way it works is you can't outright slay the beast. Look at this guy, still dead here. Dead to rights. Yeah, and we are essentially headed that way. Oh right, totally forgot that I didn't have a spell going to cast anything yet. thankfully though. I don't really need them per se. So that's the werewolf right there. And you can see Crystalda Astley standing right next to him. Well, right within him actually. I do not want to hit you, Crystalda. Why don't you come here instead? Crystalda. Be a darling and move aside with you. So yeah, we can't exactly just go out all out and hit him. So what we essentially needed to do was make sure that we hit him once, get him below a certain level, and just wait 5 seconds. And if that doesn't show any difference, we have to hit him again. So that is exactly what we did here. We don't want to kill this guy. You can do that, but we don't want to. We just want to lower his health and let her use her magic. As the body of the werewolf slowly freezes in place, Crystalda actually speaks. Excellent, strange bird. I'll keep my promise to tell you what I know of that letter you're after. I well remember Sindasa blabbering on about the queen's private affairs. Amazing what a few drops of wine will do to loosen a young girl's tongue. It isn't just every day a letter from the emperor is delivered, especially as, you know, the queen isn't all that fond of him. Sindasa said that the letter was the only one she'd ever seen from him, and was shocked when the queen gasped and exclaimed, "Why, this isn't for me, it's addressed to Minasera." Poor Sindasa. She immediately thought that she'd misunderstood the courier and given that letter to the wrong noble. She was so relieved when Obuki didn't make a fuss and said she'd make sure the queen mother got it promptly, and not to worry herself over it. I see. So Obuki never actually gave the letter to the queen mother. But why was it addressed to Obuki though? That's like the strangest part here. Now, if I might beg the favor of escorting us to the Beldama of the Sisters of the Bluff. You'll find it on the map in the Daggerfall province. Sure. Oh, look at that guy on the left there. I'm gonna save you. An evil laugh echoes past. I don't really need Loomis, to be honest. The game looks bright enough as is. And we are headed back out of this place then. Had to cast food just to get up there. So I feel sort of stupid looking for the third diary entry when there were only two. But then again, Daggerfall can't be like that. I mean, even though we got the first diary entry itself, that would have been sufficient. Daggerfall would more or less insist on the last entry there. Okay, so we need to head where again? Excuse me. To the Coven on the Bluff in Daggerfall. I see. It really did. It was a mouthful of a name. Coven on the Bluff. So I don't know if they're gonna do an expose or not. Holy shit, that's black. I see. Travel cost 80. 3 days time, sure. So where are we headed again? Apparently the Coven on the Bluff there. Strange Blood, your service to the Coven has been invaluable. Please feel free to call at any time. Wait, what? Where's the Coven on the Bluff? Like, where's the Coven? Excuse me? Did it, like, not render in or something? I mean, the wilderness looks nice and everything, but the Coven is sort of supposed to render in, you know? And we're supposed to wait here for like 5 seconds till it occurs, but I guess there's supposed to be a Coven here, but nothing here? So yeah, since they did not like do a grand expose, here are the facts of the matter. We're not headed back to Daggerfall yet, Masterfield Cemetery. We learned what we had to learn from these guys, but I'm gonna head over to Minivia next, to essentially Minivia, to complete quest for the Mage Guild. Right. So this werewolf was actually Sindasa's brother, none other than Sindasa's brother, and she shockingly had him turned into a werewolf. Well, that is shocking indeed. Fight is good. Where were we headed again? Sorry. the Mage Guild right there, yes. I'm sad that I didn't get to see the Coven, though it was literally in the middle of nowhere. I guess that's one of the disadvantages of using this mod, but oh well. It is what it is. Anyhow, so our teleport anchor is sort of going to waste at this point in time. It's right in front of us. Right. So Sindasa essentially turned her brother into a werewolf. And this brother... Oh yeah, let me go ahead and equip this instead of that. right?
Hmm.
So, yeah, it's quite sad the way things turned out. If there was a better way for them to turn out, it would have been nice, but unfortunately, there does not seem to be any better way. Seem to have been any better way for it to turn out. So, with that being said, that was it for this quest. I forgot the name of this quest, actually. At any rate, the next time we come back, we will be covering some quests for the Mage's Guild. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings. I am sort of happy, though, that that man gets to live with his lover the way it was supposed to be. At any rate, the mystery of the Queen's letter thickens at this point.